and hopped aboard what they call a train to a country that really was number one in education.
Finland is ranked at or near the top of having the best educated students in the world, which left everyone wondering, really? Finland?
These are the people who gave us the air guitar championship.
Hello? Hello?
And the sports of cell phone throwing and wife carrying. These are the geniuses that cracked the code to good education. I mean, how is it that the kids in Finland are ahead of the rest of the world? So here's what happened. Back in the day, Finland's schools sucked on the level that ours suck on. When they tested the world's kids, both Finland and us were usually about the same, you know, somewhere down the list of nations. But Finland didn't like that. So they tried some new ideas, and in no time, Finland shot to the top of the world. Their students were number one. How did they do that? That was the one question I wanted an answer to, and I went straight to see the enemy's Minister of Education. Before I could say anything, she blurted out their top secret.
They do not have homework.
Wait, so you reduce the homework you give them in school?
Yes. They should have more time to be kids, to be youngsters, to enjoy the life.
How many hours of homework did you get last night?
About 10 minutes or something.
10 minutes of homework.
Yeah. Maybe 15 minutes or 20 minutes.
20 minutes, but not so much. Yeah.
Well, if I would have done the homework, I think it would be like 10 minutes tops.
Usually I don't really do homework that much.
The whole term homework is kind of obsolete, I think. In that way that...
Your homework is obsolete.
Yeah. In that way that these kids, they have a lot other things to do after school.
Like what?
Like being together, like being with a family, doing sports, like playing music, like reading.
So they have no homework. What if all they want to do is climb a tree?
They could climb a tree, yeah. They can climb a tree, then they learn how to climb a tree. But they'll end up, while climbing the tree, probably finding out about different insects, and they can come to school next day telling me about what they found.
Compared to the older kids, how many hours a day do the younger ones go to school?
Mondays, 3 hours. Tuesdays, 4 hours. It varies. It's 20 hours a week.
So they're. Now, does this 3 or 4 hours at school include the lunch hour?
Yes.
How are they learning anything? How are you getting anything done?
Your brain has to relax every now and then. If you just constantly work, then you stop learning. And there's no use of doing that for a longer period of time.
Finland students have the shortest school days and the shortest school years in the entire Western world. They do better by going to school less.
Yay!
How many languages do you speak?
English, yeah. Swedish, Spanish.
Finnish and Swedish. Finnish, English and German.
French, German.
Finnish and English.
English, Swedish and French and Spanish.
So you were an exchange student in the U.S.?
Yeah.
When you got back here in school, what did you notice that you felt relieved about?
No more multiple choice exams.
No multiple choice exams here?
Or very few of them, if any.
Really?
All of my exams in the U.S.
How do you answer the question right if it isn't listed as one of the four choices?
You write your answer.
You have to know it, actually.
Yeah.
You actually have to know it.
Yeah.
If there was one thing I heard over and over again from the Finns, it was that America should stop teaching to a standardized test.
Get rid of those standardized tests.
National testing.
The standardized tests.
The standardized testings.
What you are teaching your students is to do well on those tests, and you're not really teaching them anything.
No, we are teaching them. We're teaching them how to flunk a test, and then a bunch of schools fail the test, and those schools are turned into charter schools, and then somebody makes a lot of money.
But school is about finding your happiness, finding what, you know, finding a way to learn,
What makes you happy?
They figure now about one third of the school time the students are in school is spent preparing for the standardized test. And so they've eliminated a lot of things that aren't on the test. So music is gone, art is gone, poetry is gone. Yeah, in many schools.
Civics isn't even on the test. So now schools are dropping.
Really?
Civics, yes. Civics, American civics.
Okay. Unbelievable.
We got rid of poetry.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah.
Why?
It's a waste of time. When are they ever going to learn? When are they ever going to speak as poets when they're adults? How does that help them get a job?
We try to teach them everything that they need so that they could actually use their brain as well as they can, including PE, including arts, including music, anything that can actually make brain work better.
The children need to be baking, they should be singing, they should be doing art and going on nature walks and doing all these things because there's this very short time that they're allowed to be children.
If you don't have standardized tests here in Finland, how do you know which schools are the best? And, you know, people need a list.
The neighborhood school is the best school. It is not different than the school which can be, for example, situated in the town center, because all the schools in Finland,
they are all equal.
When we move to a new city, we never ask where the best school is. It's never a question.
So nobody has to shop for schools.
There's nothing different in any of our schools. They are the same.
It is illegal in Finland to set up a school and charge tuition. That's why, for the most part, private schools don't exist. And what that means is that the rich parents have to make sure that the public schools are great. And by making the rich kids go to school with everyone else, they grow up with those other kids as friends. And when they become wealthy adults, they have to think twice before they screw them over.
In the United States, education is a business. There are corporations making money. Here, it's so student-centered that when we had to redo our playground, they had the architects come in and talk to the kids for the playground.
Were they listened to?
Yes. Yes, there are things on our playground that the students really wanted.
Being in school here is more independent.
We're created more like adults than in the United States.
Yeah.
I mean, we don't need a hall pass to go to the bathroom during class.
Yeah.
We'll see students commuting on the subway, even as young as 7 and 8, going on their own to school.
When I started doing teacher training practice back in the U.S., I was in these certain neighborhoods, teaching these kids and telling them, you can be anything you want to be when you grow up. This is kind of a lie. And when I came to Finland, a lot of my teaching is based on what the kids want and what they see for their future. So it doesn't feel so false to say you can really be whatever you want to be when you grow up, because they're making it happen. Already, they already have such power.
That's upsetting to think about that. Hmm. That our kids don't have that. Hmm. That's really beautiful.
It's not that we have figured out something that nobody else has done in education. That's wrong. Many of these things that have made Finland perform well in education are initially American ideas.
We try to teach them to think for themselves and to be critical to what they're learning.
We try to teach them to be happy person, to be respect others and respect yourself.
You're concerned with their happiness.
Oh yeah. Mm-hmm.
What the hell do you teach?
I teach math.
So the math teacher says the first thing out of your mouth of what you wanted these students to get out of school was to be happy, to have a happy life.
Yeah.
And you're the math teacher.
Yeah.
When do they have their time to play and socialize with their friends and grow as human beings? Because there's so much more life around than just school.
You want them to play?
I want children to play.
And that was the principle.
I'm planting the American flag right here in the middle of your school and claiming this great idea for us.
Thanks for stealing it.
Yeah, that's how we roll.
All right.
I'm just saying.